Yeah, this is a pretty sweet hand. Core Firewalker is actually pretty good with equipment since he can't actually kill it except for with Go for the Throat, which he does board in, I assume. But can't at least doesn't run into Arc Trail, so if I go turn one Steplings, turn two Core Firewalker, I don't actually have to worry about getting Arc Trailed. Get to be on the draw here. Not sure how he sides. He might take out like Last Raiders. They don't seem very good in this matchup. Ooh, a little sparky there. But if I'm running Cunning Spark Mages, then the Pulse Trackers actually are kind of loose too. Probably don't want to take out Viscerous here. That guy's pretty good. And probably wouldn't have sided out Blood Gas like he did in last game. By that I mean I just got very, very lucky. Yeah, might as well get in my hits while I can. I'm going for a Plains anyway. If he's got removal, he's got removal. I mean, he doesn't have Disfigure, I don't think, but he definitely could be killing one of the guys next turn. Alright, so Core Firewalker doesn't match up all that well against like the Gatekeeper he's going to play here. So I might actually just... Ooh, Highborn. That doesn't bother me too much. Scalding Tarn. And... now I get to ping his dude, and if he wants to Lightning Bolt, well, he would have bolted the Steplings. Ooh, and side benefit, I gain life. It's actually not irrelevant, I would say. All right, so I ping his guy, so that way he has to scry now and drain him, and he cannot block. Otherwise, he could just block, and it would save him extra damage here. Definitely don't want him chumping my 4-5 Steplings. And I will trade Core Firewalker for Calastria Highborn, as it turns out. Let's see if he is willing to make that trade. Nope. Could very easily be getting Arc Trailed here, which would be unfortunate, but I would at least gain a life. He's got four cards in hand, so... Go for the throw at that guy, and then Arc Trail my guys. Ooh, alright. Very cunning. Well, there goes my board. Let's see if Spike Shot Elder is good enough by himself, since apparently that's all I've got. See, siding in Gideon's and Elspeth sound nice, but when... Or, sorry, Gideon and Inferno Titan sounds nice, but when you don't draw any of them, it doesn't actually do much. Alright. Well, the Keeper of the Gate is here. Now I do need to draw one of those things. I mean, Gideon minus two on Highborn would not be bad here. Ooh, well, there goes one of my mana sinks. Let's get some Hawks. Little Hawk action. Land, and another Hawk. Alright, so now, at the very least, I can double block Highborn. I mean, that runs into Bolt pretty bad, but I'm beyond the point where I can play around anything. Alright, so he does not send with Highborn. I'm still, I think, going to double block here, since just taking it isn't going to help. I'm not killing him anytime soon, and if I take it, then I just take extra damage. I'm going to have to kill those guys eventually. Alright, let's hope he doesn't have too much more. Last year. Alright, so they did not come out. Cunning Spark Mage, huh? Let's play a Squadron Hawk. Not search. And I guess I'll play another Squadron Hawk. Alright. I don't like the spot I'm in here. I mean, then again, Boros is a 26 land deck, so there are limitations for that. Like, I mean, he's got himself a 23 or 22 land deck, whatever Vampires plays, maybe 24. Some amount less than 26. Alright, so at least he's not got a whole lot of gas. He's probably just bashing me here with, I guess, not everything. Alright, let's kill the Lava Claw Reaches since don't get drained and it does more damage in combat. Could have played Cunning Spark Mage there. Does an extra point to him by not doing it because he bleeds off Lacerator for a turn. Alright, now I think we're screwed. I guess Spark Mage plus Hawk would team up to take a 2-2 down, so I should have definitely have played Spark Mage last turn. I suspect I'm still doomed, but there's no excuse not to play well. And by playing Spark Mage Hawk next turn, I would basically just have a Hawk in play right now, as opposed to nothing. Alright, we'll take it and hope to draw Basilisk Caller, I think, is my best out. So if I traded with that, I would be still at 5, though he couldn't attack with Highborn as easily. If he had any spell, I was dead, but such as that one. Alright, sure, let's do that. I guess that makes my Gideon plan not as good. But, alright, so I go to 3. Yeah, it looks like faux pas with the spark mage or not, I think I was dead. Not that it excuses it, but I'd like the games to at least have a reasonable conclusion. All right, so we're done here. I think so, yeah.